And now, let's meet our championship finalists. First, the non-starters for Wekiva. Tonight's visitors, with a record of 25 wins and 2 losses. Number 0, Jade Lewis. Number 1, Sarai Lumsden. Number 3, Tiara Coleman. Number 21, Christina Wright. Number 23, Zariah Hercule. And number 24, Madeline Tuesday. Introducing the non-starters for St. Thomas Aquinas, tonight's home team with a record of 26 wins and 4 losses. Number 1, Cameron Corcoran. Number 5, Jade Wright. Number 10, Dakota Degenhart. Number 12, Raina Green. Number 21, Nyla McFadden. Number 22, Alexia Wimbley. Number 24, Alexandra Bishop.
Good evening from the RP Funding Center in Lakeland, Florida. It's where we're going to crown the 6A state champion in a rematch of last year's 6A state championship game, the Wekiva Mustangs taking on the St. Thomas Aquinas Raiders here on Spectrum Sports. Mike Aarons along with Andrick Frazier from inside the RP Funding Center expecting a good one. This was a 2-point game last year, won by St. Thomas. And Wekiva looking for a little revenge. Here's how they both got here, both of them with relative ease. St. Thomas took out Nice in the semifinals of Kiva over Bloomingdale easily, setting up tonight's matchup, 26-4 and 25-2. Let's meet some of the key players we'll be focusing on in this game, starting with the sophomore from Wekiva, Jada Eads, averaged over 17 points a game, which included a 47-point game earlier this season against Colonial. And she'll definitely have some scoring help from the senior, Ryland Moffitt. Over 9 points a game on the season, but impressive 46% from the field. She averaged almost a double-double. She had 14 points and 11 rebounds in the 6A semifinals.
Six-foot senior Moffitt can really stroke it from the outside as well, an inside-outside punch. 53 rebounds as a team against Bloomingdale, which saw Eads with 21 points, 5 rebounds, and 3 steals in the semifinal.
Sorry, partner. I can't forget my partner. On the other side, we have Karina Gordon for St. Thomas Aquinas, 13 points a game, 3 rebounds, and almost 2 assists. She came up with 19 points and 5 steals in the 6A semifinal.
5-for-9 junior really leads this ball club that predicates their winning tradition on defense. Forced 39 turnovers in the semifinal game the other night. Let's see if they can heat up the Wekiva ball club again like they did last year down the stretch and come away with the victory.
Take a look at the starting lineup for the Mustangs. Along with Eads, you got Shayna McCarthy, Amaria Gordon, Moffitt, and Kanari Holiday. 3 seniors and 2 sophomores for head coach Tommy Butts, who's in his 10th season at Wekiva. Over 226 wins, his 6th title game appearance. He's 2-3, and he's looking to even that up tonight. On the other sideline for the Raiders, Maya Williams, Karina Gordon, Brianna Gustave, Alancia Ramsey's one to watch for sure, along with Jader Green. So a junior and senior laden lineup for head coach Oliver Behrens in his 5th season for the Raiders. Over 100 wins in his career with the Raiders, and making his 3rd title game appearance at 1-1 and looking to go back to back against the Mustangs tonight.
Introducing the head coaches, first for Wekiva in his 16th season.
If it sets up like last year, it was tight down to the wire. Wekiva had the lead late in that game, remember, partner? And St. Thomas Aquinas came back and took it away, and they ended up winning by two.
Ended up making great defensive plays down the stretch, and I'll tell you what, knowing Coach Tommy Butts like I have over the years, he has been focused on this day for the last 364 days of the year, waiting for an opportunity to get a chance for a little bit of vengeance.
All right, we're getting a chance to kick this one off. The 6A state champ, 32 minutes, will be crowned. St. Thomas Aquinas and Wekiva in a rematch of last year's 6A state championship game. Kenari Holiday in the circle, a pair of 32s, and Alancia Ramsey for the Raiders. Officials getting set, we're getting set. Sit back and enjoy the 6A state championship game from Lakeland as the Raiders win the tap and go to work as Maya Williams runs the offense for Oliver Behrens. Three ball from the wing, that one came up just short. Brianna Guste firing it up. Fight for the loose ball, Canary Holiday comes down with it. Back the other way come the Mustangs. Wekiva in black, St. Thomas Aquinas in the white uniforms. Welcome those watching on Spectrum as we get ready to crown another state champion here on Championship Saturday here in Lakeland.
Wekiva will surely want to push the basketball every opportunity they get with their great guards.
Now we got some free throws coming early. That's Jada Eads. We focused on her before the game.
Only 5'6", but tough as nails. Sophomore really has a high basketball IQ.
Leading scorer for the Mustangs, averaging over 17 points, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists a game. She shot 71% during the season from the line, and she makes both of her free throws. And to mention, that's a 47-point game this year against Colonials. She had 21 points and 5 rebounds in the semis. So she gets the first 2 points of the afternoon, and we are underway.
She is surely no stranger to playing big games.
Maya Williams to Gustave. Alancia Ramsey and Kenari Holiday will be one to watch down to the post, a pair of 32s going at it. Nice pass to a slicing Jada Green, but she couldn't get it in.
Good job by Green on the back cut. Like I said, the partner just unable to finish.
Eads. Three ball on the way, good. Amaria Gordon, the 5'9 sophomore, 7 points and 10 rebounds, 4 assists in the semis.
Very important to get Gordon going early to loosen things up for Eads and dribble penetration.
Ryla Moffitt comes away with the basketball. Amari was feeling it from that side, so let's tee this up again, see how I'm doing.
Yeah, a little bit of a heat check there, I guess.
Kenaria Gordon on the move, try to flip it up. With the left hand, Karina Gordon just a little bit short, hit the rim. Jada Eads coming back the other way. Just underway in this 6A state championship game. Mike Aarons, Andrick Frazier, glad you could join us here this evening on Spectrum Sports. Kenari Holiday flips it up, wins the first battle against Alancia Ramsey.
Very deep post for Holiday. You cannot give up that much ground. Young lady has great footwork around the basket, such a soft touch. Sorry, using the left hand on that possession.
Jada Green pulls up off the back iron. Maya Williams comes down, Jada Eads comes down with the rebound. For Wekiva. That's Shania McCarthy. Back in the Holiday. And maybe just a little bit too much.
That was an offensive foul on that possession.
And they get her for an offensive foul, her first, team first, obviously. And Maya Williams. Ramsey got a touch, and then to Gustave. Gustave on the fly. Nice flip.
Great finish at the rim. First semblance of pressure here from the Raiders.
It's Amaria Gordon with the basketball, got it across the timeline to Eads. And she was tied up and fouled by Maya Williams. Shania McCarthy will inbound for the Mustangs, who have the early 7-2 lead here coming up on the halfway point of the first quarter.
It's like a heavyweight fight, partner. Both opponents feeling each other out.
At first look on paper, pretty evenly matched teams, I'd say. Wouldn't you say, partner?
Oh, these are teams that know each other very well. That is for sure.
A lot of faces from last year out on the court. That Shania McCarthy got inside. A good cut by McCarthy, but couldn't finish. Gustave on the run. And a foul is called.
Gustave here showing you a little bit of change of pace.
Looks like they need to get Amaria Gordon. Oh, they got to get Jade Eads. Her first. Team second. Gustave gets it to roll in. 5'7" senior. She had one of those stat sheets in the semis. She had 3 points, 3 rebounds, 4 assists, and 2 steals. So she did a little bit of everything, including shoot free throws well.
One of those players is going to bring their lunch pail and hard hat to work every day.
McCarthy gets away from the double team. Amaria Gordon across the timeline. She's bothered there by Karina Gordon.
Great ball pressure by the Raiders.
Shania McCarthy hits the deck.
Foul on number 11, Jada Green. Her first 13 foul.
Jada Green comes up with the foul, her first.
Both teams here whistle for 5 fouls, not even 4 minutes into the contest.
Here comes Gustave on the run. Doesn't go, nice rebound. Cameron Corcoran, who just checked in for St. Thomas Aquinas, number one. And they're going to call her for a little over the back. We've got the body. She's trying to pull down that rebound. It's 7-4 halfway through this first quarter. Again, two teams that know each other very well, just kind of feeling each other out a little bit in the 6A state championship rematch of a year ago. McCarthy, Gustave.
Nice pass.
Eads to Rylan Moffitt, and she delivers. The 6-foot senior, beautiful pass from Eads. Moffitt's on the scoreboard. She had a double-double in the semis. Lancia Ramsey trying to get going as well, but Kanari Holiday doing a great job defensively. The battle between the 32s, I think, is going to be a great battle to watch tonight.
Ramsey did a great job, I think, on the bounce pass, at least attempt.
Corcoran to inbound. Corcoran got it back from Green. Moffitt came down with the rebound. Just an interesting little step through.
Just come to a jump stop and shoot a little mid-range jumper, you know?
Holiday trying to back down Ramsey. They called again.
That is an awful call. It's 2 offensive fouls on the block.
That is 2 fouls.
She posts up here. Reverse spin move. I don't see where the offensive foul is. I don't see it. If anything, that's a no call and play through.
Ramsey gets a touch. Back to Corcoran inside to Ramsey. Nice pass. Great little cut there.
Great back screening.
They definitely need to get number 32 on the board. Moffitt on the handoff to Eads. Eads amongst the trees, but can't get it to go. But Moffitt keeps it in bounds to Amaria Gordon. And Shania McCarthy's going to back it out. Gustave on her. Eads on the cut. He's going to fire. Good. Three-pointer for Jada Eads.
Raiders are doing the best they can to try to keep the basketball out of Eads' hands. Not successful in that possession.
12-6 coming up on 2 minutes left here in the opening quarter of the 6A state championship game. Corcoran got around but couldn't finish. And Eads with the basketball back the other way for Wekiva. A little too strong. For Shania McCarthy. Ramsey. Nobody there. And Gustave pulls down the rebound. Good hustle. Good ball movement here. And a three ball on the way is good from Karina Gordon. Timeout called on the floor with 1:13 left here in the opening quarter. 12-9 early on here, partner.
We are in for a dog fight this afternoon. That is for sure. Right here, just, you know, thought a great job of Eads sacrificing her body. No call made there, but Gordon spacing the floor. Extra pass by Green. Leads to the three-point opportunity and bucket for the Raiders.
You know, when I first saw that move there, I thought, now they called the two fouls, and they didn't call that. But then when I looked at the replay, that looked a little floppy to me, partner. It looked a little floppy.
I can understand the floppy, but that was a noppy on the play before that, if that was a floppy.
Yeah, well, when I first saw that live, I thought, you didn't call that, but you called the two down there. Why?
I think sometimes, too, the officials get caught up in the size differential and the aggression,
okay,
especially that Holiday plays with. But, you know, if there's nothing intentional, there's no hooking, there's no dislodging, you're really not creating an advantage physically. It's a tough call to make. But, you know, Holiday with her second foul.
Yeah.
I was having to go to the bench, and I'm not sure if we'll see her again in the first half.
Yeah, that's a good point. And let's see what that does, foul call. Let's see what that does for Alancia Ramsey in her matchup now, because the two of them before, that was a great matchup. Ramsey might have some more opportunities because she can really get things going down on the post. All right, final minute here of this first quarter. Mustangs with a 12-9 lead, looking to extend. And they do. Jade Lewis with the three ball. Lewis just checked in off the timeout. Makes her presence felt, the 5'7 junior.
Big possession here for the Raiders, partner.
Gustave couldn't get it to go. Fights, battles for the rebound. 30 seconds left. Corcoran tracks it down. Great pass underneath back to Gustave, and that's good for two. What a pass.
Mustangs caught scrambling that possession. Left Gustave wide open underneath the basket.
Just a bullet of a pass by Corcoran. Eads on the spin move. Gustave with the rebound. 7 seconds and counting. Time running out. And with 1 second left, it's going the other way.
Got to recognize time and score there if you're going to stay. Pull the basketball out. Just make sure you get the last shot.
Raina Green going to check in for Cameron Corcoran. Raina Green, a junior. And that's how the first quarter will come to an end. Great first quarter in this 6A state championship rematch here in Lakeland. Wekiva out to the early lead after one. 15-11 here on Spectrum Sports.
The Florida High School Athletic Association recognizes its corporate partners who help make the FHSAA Girls Basketball Championships possible. Team IP, official merchandising company of the FHSAA. Gatorade, fueling the future. Balfour, makers of official FHSAA championship rings.
Welcome back to the RP Funding Center in Lakeland. 6A state championship game here on Spectrum Sports. The Wekiva Mustangs leading the St. Thomas Aquinas Raiders after 115-11. And we talked about the history between these two. Here's a little playoff history. Take you back. For Wekiva, 9 playoff appearances, 29-6 postseason record. Of course, their best finish was a pair of state championships in 14-19. For the Raiders, 16 playoff appearances, also 29 postseason wins. And their best finish, the defending state champs, knocked off Wekiva last year 62-60 in the final. So even the postseason records are almost the same for these two squads.
Yeah, these two ball clubs have become very familiar with each other the course of the last 3 to 4 years.
Now the Raiders will start the second quarter with the ball. Karina Gordon to Brianna Gustave, and we're underway. 15-11 lead for the Mustangs.
Cobb here going to a 2-3 zone.
It's going to stay with the Raiders.
Quick hands there by Coleman.
Substitution for St. Thomas Aquinas.
Cameron Corcoran will come in for Raina Green. Notice that we did not see Kanari Holiday to start the second quarter, still on the bench with two fouls. That's Karina Gordon with the ball. Lila Moffat on her. And down to Alancia Ramsey. And this is where I think they can take advantage with Kanari Holiday on the bench. But you got to finish. You got to make points down there.
Not sure how many looks she'll get that'll be that easy the rest of the evening.
Rylan Moffat turns and delivers.
Talked about the inside-outside ability of Moffat. See, they're sticking her nose in the paint.
Green, nice turnaround. Delivers Jada Green, 17-13. Mustangs. Timeout being called.
Timeout, St. Thomas.
Oliver Behrens.
Raiders call 30-second timeout. Thank you to the following championship.
Well, we got a timeout here with 6:52 left to go. Take a look at the Mustangs' muscle the last 8 seasons. The state championship in 13, 14, then runner-up. Then they finally got back as a state championship in 2018, 2019. And a couple of state runner-up finishes after that in a row into this state final. So they've been here 3 years in a row. And much like St. Thomas Aquinas, they're pretty familiar with the big stage here, and you can see both of these teams are pretty comfortable playing right now at this time of game, what this game means, and right here on this floor.
And you know, he's Coach Butts and his ball club here to put up those type of numbers facing some pretty stiff competition. Battle tested and trying to see if they can get the trophy back on their side this year.
Maria Gordon lifts, delivers short, and back the other way comes Raina Green. And the Raiders, Green lost the handle. Loose ball picked back up by Green as they swatted around on the floor. Karina Gordon, Gustave's gonna fire for three. Nice rebound by Jada Green. And the stick back, 2-point game.
Jada Green does such a good job of moving her feet once the ball is in the air, getting position for offensive rebounds.
Reball on the way. That one off the front rim by Jada Eads. Reball from the corners off the mark by Raina Green. And the stick back by Brianna Gusta.
Right now the Raiders living off the offensive glass. Wekiva not doing a great job of limiting the Raiders to one and done on the offensive end.
Lila Moffitt too strong. Raina Green. Karina Gordon underneath. Gordon came down with the rebound. And the foul on the Mustangs. Jade Lewis gets called for her first foul. Team foul number four for Wekiva. St. Thomas with five team fouls. About 5 minutes left to go in this first half. At the RP Funding Center in Lakeland, Mike Cairns and Rick Frazier here on Spectrum Sports. Glad you could be with us tonight in this 6A state championship game. Marina Gordon directing a little traffic, moving people around, setting in motion. Three ball coming up short by Jada Green. Eads bounces it off her foot right to Rylan Moffitt. That's the kind of bounce you want.
Sometimes it just pays to be in the right place at the right time, partner.
Tierra Coleman checking in, number three for Wekiva. She's at the top of the key. In the backcourt with Jada Eads. Aquinas settling into their zone. Eads is open. Step around. Good. It's a two. Stepped on the line. Jade Lewis with another bucket. And the answer on the other end.
What a move by the senior. I think she's playing a little bit of a sense of urgency here tonight.
Yeah, I think she is. Brianna Gustav has had a good first half. 8 points, 5 rebounds already here in this opening half. Moffitt turns and fires. Rebound, Jada Green. Moffitt is tasked with trying to hold off Alancia Ramsey, and she's worried about her, and right down the middle goes Karina Gordon. And a timeout is called. 3:26 left to go in this first half.
Gordon utilizing the ball screen and just going downhill. I mean, you really can't show too hard from the corner because Green shoots the basketball fairly well from the outside.
Raiders on a little bit of a run here to take a 21-19 lead. And here's what they've done under Oliver Behrens. State runners-up in 2018-2019 and then state championship last season. And back as a state finalist and into the 6A state championship game in 21-22. So Oliver Behrens has been very successful in his years as head coach at St. Thomas Aquinas. You take a look at the crowd. Plenty of fans on hand. St. Thomas Aquinas fans sitting behind us. Defend the ship, that's what the shirt says.
It never amazed me with the creativity of some of the fan bases.
You gotta love it, gotta love it. So Kanari Holiday has checked back in for Wekiva. With 3:26 left to go, she's got two fouls.
Mustangs ball.
Wekiva basketball. Jade Lewis will inbound to Jada Eaves. Down by two. Little run by St. Thomas Aquinas have given them the lead. Right down they go to Kanari Holiday. And Kanari Holiday meets up with Alancia Ramsey down underneath. Mustang knocks down the first one, the 5'7 senior. Did a little bit of everything in that semifinals. 3 points, 3 rebounds, 4 assists, and a couple steals. And she knocks down both of her free throws to extend the Raiders' lead. 23-19, under three to go. Here in the first half.
See if the Mustangs can come up with an answer.
McCarthy tried to get it inside. Lancer Ramsey off her foot. Tried to get it back down inside. They keep trying to feed Kanari Holiday down on the post.
Nice screen.
Maria Gordon. And she will go to the line. And a chance to pull the Mustangs a little closer.
Moffitt here with the ball screen, and Jada Green just not stepping up high enough.
Sixth team foul for St. Thomas Aquinas. Puts the 5'9 sophomore on the line. Really nice semifinal for Maria. 7 points, 10 rebounds, had 4 assists. Another one of those young players that coach is real excited about.
Substitution for St. Thomas Aquinas, number 1, Cameron Corcoran.
His only underclassman that he starts, has a lot of seniors, but rolls in some off the bench. We've already seen Tierra Coleman, who's a sophomore. Jade Lewis is playing a big part for Coach Betts. He likes what he has in Amaria Gordon for sure. Gustav on the drop-off. Jada Green delivers. Jada Green's had a nice little first half as well for St. Thomas Aquinas.
Making a living from 15 feet.
25-21. Maria Gordon thought about it. Trying to use the screen there. Gets around the screen for 3. Off the side iron. Great rebound underneath by Kanari Holiday. Another rebound, and she sticks it back up, but it rolls across the back of the rim.
3 straight misses from point-blank range.
And Cameron Corcoran with a basketball. Under 2 to play. Lancia Ramsey on Holiday. And a turnover.
Thought Ramsey definitely wanted to maybe try to draw a foul on that possession on Holiday. Happy feet for a second.
Yeah. Nyla McFadden checking in for St. Thomas Aquinas. Eads with the basketball, down by 4. Coming up on a minute left. Gordon on the move. Lancia Ramsey's there to shut her down. Loose ball. Moffitt picks it up to Eads, who's going to fire for 3. That's good. Jada Eads drills the 3, and it's a 1-point game. Under a minute to play.
It's great court awareness on that possession by Moffitt. Coming up with the loose ball and finding Eads.
Nice move by Karina Gordon to get to the basket, and she delivered. Back and forth they go here in this opening half at the RP Funding Center in Lakeland, 6A state championship game. Wekiva and St. Thomas Aquinas. Dana McCarthy said, why not? I'll take a straight on look at a 3. Kanari Holiday underneath, battling for the loose ball along with Lancia Ramsey. And it'll be Raiders' ball.
Raiders in possession. Substitutions for St. Thomas Aquinas, number 1, Cameron Corcoran.
Cameron Corcoran checks back in. She'll come in for Nyla McFadden. Under 10 seconds left to go here. Corcoran on the move, tried to get Ramsey, and time is going to run out. That's how things will end in this first half from the RP Funding Center. 16 minutes in the books of the 6A state championship rematch, and St. Thomas Aquinas with a nice little run in the second quarter on a 27-24 halftime lead here on Spectrum Sports.
Team IP, the official merchandise company of the FHSAA. Florida Dairy Farmers is a proud supporter of student athletes and their families. Farmers know it takes hard work and long hours to excel in the classroom and on the court. Visit floridamilk.com to see how dairy farmers across the Sunshine State work hard every day to provide fresh, wholesome milk. Eat like a Lakelander. Country Chicken and Fish is conveniently located on Kathleen Road and serving award-winning Southern favorites. After the game, Visit Central Florida invites you to explore everything else Central Florida has to offer. From thrilling rides at Legoland Florida Resort, to exotic animals at Safari Wilderness, to delicious local cuisine everywhere you turn. Plan your next trip now at visitcentralflorida.com. Attention fans, as a friendly reminder, any streaming of these games are prohibited as enforced by the FHSAA. Once again, any streaming of these games are prohibited as enforced by the FHSAA. Thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to the RP Funding Center here on Spectrum Sports, getting ready for the second half of the 6A state championship game with St. Thomas leading Wekiva 27-24. Take a look at the first half stats of this one, and what sticks out to you, partner?
A lot of balance. I mean, I think that the two biggest differences so far has been the rebounding by St. Thomas Aquinas, their ability to be aggressive against second chance point opportunities. The only reason why, honestly, they're leading this game right now. Wekiva shooting the basketball fairly decently from the outside, 4-for-10 from three. Both teams four for four, from the foul line. But the points in the paint. We thought coming into this that Wekiva would have that advantage with Holiday. Her being saddled with two fouls early on in the first half has really hurt the Mustangs.
Well, we are seeing a pattern with teams that make it to the state championship, and that's the teams that you play during the regular season. And we're seeing more and more throughout the state, the more successful teams stack their schedule full of tough opponents, and none tougher than the schedule that the Raiders have. Take a look at this. You have Dr. Phillips, 7A finalist, ranked sixth in Florida, Central Point Christian, Bearden first in Tennessee, St. John Vianney, that's ranked fourth in the United States, King's Academy, 3A semifinals, DME Academy, ranked 14th. You got American Heritage and Miami Christian, who both won championships, and that's a pattern that we see more and more. Coaches are not afraid to play up, and in most cases, play really good competition wherever it is.
You have some coaches who really want to play for records, right? They want to try to win 30 games in the season and try to get those things done. Then you have coaches who want to play for trophies. They want to play for medals. And these are two ball clubs, and their coaches believe in playing for medals year in and year out. They would go 0-22 into districts knowing if they played a battle test of schedule to get them to here in Lakeland on the last Saturday in February.
Absolutely. And we're seeing that more and more, that that is one thing in common with a lot of Final Four and championship teams. If you look at the teams they've played, just some amazing competition. Lancey Ramsey stole the pass and then collided. Looked like collided heads. It's Shayna McCarthy. Making her way back up the court. She looks like she's okay. Canary Holiday comes down with the rebound for Wekiva. McCarthy still holding on to the side of her face as she runs back into position. Ramsey went back, looked like the back of her head got her on the side, and there's that step through by Holiday.
Both of those things, I think their heads collide. Hopefully there's no blood for either one of them, and be able to shake it off, but trust me, yeah, they might feel it tomorrow, but right now, no pain until there are zeros and a red buzzer on the clock.
Yeah, McCarthy's still trying to shake it off. Three ball on the way by Karina Gordon.
What a rebound. Oh,
great.
How could
rebound.
That not be a foul?
By Alancia Ramsey. Then a couple of rebounds by Jada Green.
That was a very dangerous play. Ramsey comes flying in, weak side for the bound, and just underneath her. I mean, that's a clear foul by Holiday.
Well, Lancia Ramsey's taking a couple of shots here in the opening of this third quarter. Collided with Shayna McCarthy and then took that shot there to the floor on the rebound. Take a look at what's at stake for these two teams in this 6A rematch for the Mustangs to be the third state title in the school's history, second title in the last four seasons. And for the Raiders, maybe the second state title in school history, and back-to-back it would be 6A state titles. You mentioned at the top of this broadcast that it was a close battle last year. It was a two-point basketball game. We got a one-point game right now. So will it be back-to-back for St. Thomas, or will it be a little revenge for the Mustangs? That's where we're at with 6:49 to go in this third quarter, and a good crowd on hand here at the RP Funding Center in Lakeland as you take a look at Alancia Ramsey coming back in. She looks like she's okay. A good sign. But there is Shayna McCarthy. She looks like she's coming back in too. Nope, she's heading over to the bench. Still took the shot there to the side of the face. You can see her going, kind of rubbing her eye a little bit. Back to live action. Mustangs down one with the basketball. Ryla Moffitt almost has it stolen away by Maya Williams.
Oh, this 3-2 zone is causing a little bit of fits for the Mustangs.
Eads was short with the three. Jade Lewis came up with the rebound. She's going to go shoot three. You know, the sophomore at the line, the leading scorer for the Mustangs. He's kind of shaking that right hand that she... Yeah, Brianna Gustav kind of made contact with that, the right arm. Right in front of the Mustang bench.
I think they're calling that on the floor.
Yep, they are. It looks like she's coming off. She went over and stood on the free throw line. And they changed the call. Kenari Holiday came down with the basketball. Alancia Ramsey called for the foul. It's Ramsey's first and third team foul here in the third quarter. Nice pass getting inside is Eads.
Just high basketball IQ, catching the defender, not with her butt to the baseline. Face cut, easy layup.
Karina Gordon thought about it for a minute. Now she fires the three off the front rim. Kenari Holiday comes down with another rebound. Good start to the third quarter for her. Inside to Rylan Moffitt over Ramsey. Can't get it to go. And Karina Gordon comes down with a rebound. Checked by Amaria Gordon in the back and then loses the basketball to Gordon. The foul called before that shot. As both Gordons were battling for the basketball. And it'll be Aquinas ball when it's all sorted out.
This reminded me of like the Daytona 500. You know, it's like you're watching them go around the track, you know, nothing really matters to the last three or four laps, right? It's like which car has the most gas left, you know, which one has the less, you know, the best tread on their tires, which driver's the most aware. I think that's what we're in for with this contest.
Got inside perfectly, Jada Green, but couldn't finish. Nice little move with Karina Gordon. Jada Eads hits the floor. Brianna Gustav to Karina Gordon. Gordon can't get it to go. Rylan Moffitt fouled as she goes to the deck. 28-27 Wekiva.
It's the fourth team foul on the Raiders.
Substitutions for the Raiders. Jada Green going to go to the bench. Nala McFadden will be in for Aquinas. Ramsey with... Well, that'll be Maya Williams getting her second foul, along with Brianna Gustav, both with two fouls. Gordon trying to step through, but loses the basketball. Lancia Ramsey comes up with it and hands it off to Karina Gordon. Checked by Amaria Gordon.
A little bit of a sloppy start here to the third quarter.
A little physical here in the start of this third quarter. Ramsey puts the ball on the floor, goes around, and beats Holiday. Nice move around Kenari Holiday.
It's a nice move, and Holiday is saying that is my fault for not cutting off the baseline.
And just like that, it's back the other way, 29-28 St. Thomas. It's down to Holiday, and a turnover. This might be like one of those NBA playoffs. Turn it on in the fourth quarter in the final 2 minutes.
I just think right now wind is starting to get to a few of the athletes.
Ramsey. Nice touch. She gets around Kenari Holiday. 3-point cushion for the Raiders. Hoffit. Out of bounds, Raiders basketball.
Mustangs have to be just a little more patient on the offensive end. Get to a two-guard front. Get the ball rotated from side to side. Make the zone work.
Gustav. Good. Brianna Gustav, the 5'7 senior with a three.
Raiders right here on a 7-0 run.
34-28. Raiders. Eads trying to answer. Almost got a membership bounce there. Back the other way quickly come the Raiders. With a 6-point cushion, under three to go in the third. Nala McFadden fouled.
Here, just great dribble penetration by Gordon. McFadden with the power dribble, catching Lewis off her feet.
That's their third foul for Lewis. As McFadden delivers and extends St. Thomas's lead to 7. And Jade Lewis with three fouls has come out. Shayna McCarthy is back in, so that's good to see. Maria Gordon for three. Brianna Gustav comes down with it. Chased by McCarthy. Back into the offensive zone.
Nice pass.
Ramsey.
Look at her
rebound.
Working.
And finished. Little glass cleaning going on there by number 32 for St. Thomas Aquinas. 2:19 left to go here in this third quarter. And St. Thomas Aquinas on a little run here for a 10-point lead.
I think you're watching here just this inside-outside punch by Ramsey and Gustav. Ramsey just refusing to be outworked as it relates to attacking the offensive glass.
8 points for Ramsey this afternoon. And the biggest lead of the game that we've seen by either team, 10 for St. Thomas Aquinas. Coming up after this one, the big schools taking center stage. That's at 8 o'clock, Miami against Dr. Phillips.
I think we're going to be in for a good one there. I expect that to be a heavyweight bout for sure. Both programs are no stranger to this complex.
And that one is coming up on Spectrum Sports at 8 o'clock. Let's stick around for that one. Back here inside the RP Funding Center, Mike Cairns, Andrick Frazier. With 2:19 to go in the third, St. Thomas Aquinas up by 10, and Wekiva needed some points and a couple stops. Jada Eads on the drive, gives it up to McCarthy. McCarthy had it roll off. And right now the battle of the boards is being won by Aquinas, and that's probably the difference so far here in the second half, because Alancia Ramsey is controlling anything that's near.
I was going to say, to be more specific, it's being won by Ramsey.
Yeah. Karina Gordon on the floor.
Gordon here on the shot fake here in the spin. Legs get tangled up with the Eads.
Eads pleading her case. Raiders ball underneath. Karina Gordon, short on the three, gets the ball back and fouled. Maya Williams set her back up again as she cut back. And she'll go to the free throw line.
And the Raiders just the more aggressive ball club this quarter. B being rewarded with opportunities from the charity stripe.
Second foul on Amaria Gordon, fourth team foul, so each squad with four team fouls with under two to play here in third. First one on the way for the 5'9 junior. Believe it or not, that's the first missed free throw of the game. That's how good things have been going down here from the charity stripe.
And I can't even blame that one on you, partner.
No, I did not. I refrained. So she splits the pair after leading the team with 19 points in the semis. Karina Gordon. He's got eight here in the championship game. Maria Gordon trying to get around Karina Gordon. Gives it up to Eads, and Eads sticks it.
Really tough shot by Eads. Nothing is coming easy for the Mustangs.
They needed that 39-30. But they need a couple of stops. Desperately. With Alancia Ramsey controlling anything that comes off of that rim or any of that thing that comes off that backboard, they're making it tough to get any kind of second shot. LaMaria Gordon with her third foul, fifth team foul.
Makaiba may want to consider going a couple of possession zone just to force this Aquinas ball club to make some shots from the outside and not give up easy penetration.
Ziana Gustav made the first one. So Amaria Gordon will check out with three fouls. And there's your second missed free throw of the game. Jade Lewis is back in.
Nice pass.
Rylan Moffitt. And Moffitt sticks it. Goes over the top of Nala McFadden.
A little high-low post work there between Holiday and Moffitt.
8-point game. Under a minute to go. Third quarter. 6A state championship game here in Lakeland. Gustav. Good. That was a big bucket. 43-32, 11-point lead. Coming up on 30 seconds left in the quarter. Brianna Gustav has stuck that. 19 points for her and a big block by Ramsey.
See if the Raiders settle here for the last shot of the quarter.
Yeah, you can see Gustav pointing to the clock. And Karina Gordon look up. Say, we're working for that.
What a pass.
Oh, what a pass and recovery back to Gustav, but couldn't finish as Alancia Ramsey at the buzzer. Oh, off the front rim. And we have played three quarters, but this one belongs to the Raiders of St. Thomas Aquinas, the defending champs, and Alancia Ramsey making her presence known in the third quarter as we head to the final 8 minutes. St. Thomas on top of Wekiva, 43-32 here on Spectrum Sports. Welcome back. Getting set for the final 8 minutes. Will it be a repeat for the Raiders, or will it be revenge for the Mustangs? We'll find out. 43-32. They're on top. Take a look at the postseason breakdown. Aquinas' wins since the district final. Beat Blanche Ely in the district final and the regional semifinal. They won both games by 4 points, and then won the other playoff games by an average of 45.
I guess, you know, Blanche Ely just provided him a little bit of resistance. No, it is very difficult sometimes to beat a team 4 and sometimes 5 times now in this format, this new format that we have with the ranking system.
Yeah, because you get to know them so well, it's almost You don't even watch your film anymore. You go, I already know this like the back of my hand. I know who they're going to go to. I know what they're going to do in certain situations. And then you got to kind of, if you're the opposing coaches, do you try to put a wrinkle in there somewhere? I mean, if you know somebody, you've already played them so many times.
The great ones do. The great ones do try to provide wrinkles. These are emotional contests because these young ladies know each other. They grew up in the same neighborhoods. They're from the same counties, the same district. So, and especially now with travel ball, even with these two ball clubs, you see each other a lot during the course of a season.
McFadden at the free throw line delivering. 13-point lead for the Raiders is we're just underway in the fourth quarter. Well, Wekiva's got some time to figure things out, but also running out of time at the same time. McCarthy rises short. Alancia Ramsey and Moffitt tie it up. Wekiva will hang on to the possession. Jade Lewis fires for three. Nice rebound by McFadden. Strong rebound.
Hard enough to know if you noticed, but Jada Green has spent a lot of time on the bench in the second half, and the Raiders have still been able to continue to mount on this lead.
Three ball from Karina Gordon helps. And the lead now up to 16. Time for a sense of urgency as Moffitt turns and delivers. And Karina Gordon comes up with a rebound. Now the Ryland Moffitt miss. Things are taking a turn here in the fourth quarter for the Raiders' way.
Mustangs need to stop in a big way, and that's not it.
Maya Williams getting down inside with a left hand. And the lead continues to grow for St. Thomas Aquinas. Eads tried to answer, turn the ball over. Here comes Karina Gordon. She's got Gustav with her. To Gustav on the bounce pass and in. 21 points for Brianna Gustav.
Kyvan only has two timeouts left for the rest of the game. I think Coach Buss is trying to manage his timeouts with maybe his team finding a way to get a bucket.
Eads with a rainbow three. And a good time for that. But they need to get a couple of stops. Gordon going to come right down into the offensive zone. Flip it up. There's Ramsey with the rebound and the stick back. And she got some help down underneath. Well, who else? Brianna Gustav, 23 points. And a huge lead for St. Thomas Aquinas here, 5:39 to go, 54-35.
Ball just seems to be bouncing the Raiders' way. And just a massive rebound and playing through contact. I thought it may have been a foul there. Holiday, but Gustav again, just right place, right time.
That's who the ball seems to be finding right here. It's Brianna Gustav, who's had a strong second half for the Raiders, who are looking to go back-to-back here in 6A. And they're 5 minutes and 39 seconds away. If your coach bets, you better figure some things out pretty quick.
Gustav so far, 23 points and 8 rebounds this evening.
And with what Alancia Ramsey has done on the glass as well, the rebound advantage is huge in favor of the Raiders. Eads deep, three good.
The young lady is not afraid of the spotlight.
Nice move inside by Maya Williams. And she'll go shoot two. Boy, that Eads three was way downtown.
It's back-to-back threes. Eads here, just a couple of rhythm dribbles and just too much space.
That is way downtown. So Eads with 18 points for Wekiva. Maya Williams, the 5'6 senior. Nala McFadden will go sit down.
A little gamesmanship there.
Ramsey.
Oops. I'm trying to get the step on Holiday.
Sorry, partner. Sorry about that. Didn't mean to do that. Needs feeling it and got it.
Back to back.
Yes. Wow. 21 points for Jada Eads. Ramsey on Holiday. Calling for the ball. Spin move. Off the mark. Ryla Moffitt comes down with a rebound.
Who do you think's shooting this, partner?
Wait, she's not far enough out. Oh, now she is. Almost knocked down that one, too. Almost four in a row.
Oh, she traveled.
Maya Williams comes up with the basketball.
Raiders here taking a little bit of air out of the basketball. Clocks their friend.
It is indeed. Up by 14. Even with all the Eads threes. They got a little bit closer as they got it into Ramsey. Ramsey muscles it up and in.
Ramsey plays much larger than her size.
Absolutely. 10 points and 6 rebounds for her. Eads comes up short. And Jada Green came down with a rebound. Loose ball. Eads is going to pick it up. And Jada Green going to get a piece of her.
That's Green's fourth foul, I believe.
Five team fouls for St. Thomas. Green's a big part of why they've been dominating down there on the offensive and defensive glass. She's been a big help to Ramsey for sure. Deep three. Ramsey couldn't hold on to it. Dropped to the floor. Tied up by Rylan Moffitt. Possession arrow going the other way. Raiders getting possession. Ramsey, you could just see her rise above the crowd. So all I could see was a pair of arms and 32, the back of 32. Some pressure now. Gets it into the hands of Gustav. Having a great game here tonight. 23 points, 8 rebounds for her. And coming up on 3 minutes left in this 6A state championship game. Mike Aarons, Andrick Frazier on the call for this 6A rematch tonight. The second half has belonged to the Raiders.
Great floor spacing here.
Gonna eat some clock in no hurry. Got a 16 point lead. Ramsey on the back door, cut to Jada Green. McCarthy out ahead of the pack. And gets fouled.
If you're Aquinas, you have to like the ball movement, but you don't necessarily have to take a shot. Here, great job here by Eads, pitching the basketball ahead. See if McCarthy can come away. I'm sorry, partner, with two from the charity stripe.
I was looking up at the team foul situation, so both in the bonus. McCarthy good. 5'8 senior. 8 points, 11 rebounds in the semis.
Substitution for Wekiva, number 0, Jade Lewis.
Jade Lewis coming in for Kanari Holiday. Get some 3-point shooters in there for the Mustangs. Coming down the stretch here. Tommy Betts has a lot of three-point shooters on the floor right now. Gordon, Lewis, Eads, Moffitt, all three-point shooters. Eads, the head to Maria Gordon. Good job getting back by Aquinas. Moffitt is able to fire, and the rebound by Karina Gordon. Gordon on the run.
Offensive foul by Gordon. There was no need for that play for Gordon. Just get the ball across half court and back it out and use the clock.
A couple of Wekiva players on the floor. Both Lewis and Eads hit the deck.
The cameraman down here on this east side of the court have had a very tough time this evening.
Kenny and
gotta,
now Pete.
Got to keep your head on the swivel down there, gentlemen.
Absolutely. That's why our guys do such a great job. They eat pressure for breakfast. Come on. Come on. Our Spectrum Sports crew gets a heaping helping of pressure for breakfast. Eads, a couple of head fakes. And then draws a foul. Bonus situation.
He's here just trying to create something off the dribble and the spin move. Draws the contact.
Maya Williams picks up foul number three. And Jada Eads at the line. And that's good. 22 points for her. Amaria Gordon checks in for Kanari Holiday.
You have to save that substitution for the second free throw. You have to wait for the ball to get into the hands of the free throw shooter on the second free throw, so that way it's stopped. You can set up your press as opposed to having to be in a live ball.
You're also kind of freezing your own player.
Hey, you're not freezing Eads. Don't worry about that.
That's true. She's got 23 to match Brianna Gustav for St. Thomas Aquinas. They are the leading scorers in this game. We're under two to go. Maya Williams, there is Gustav.
Smart decision by Gustav. Make them foul you.
That is a senior who's been in this situation before.
Oh, bad pass. Pass has to go towards the basket.
Out of bounds, Mustangs ball.
12-point advantage. 1:26 to go. Is there enough time for a Mustang comeback?
Seeing crazier things happen. It's only four possessions, partner.
We saw it last year with the same two teams, and it was flipped. It wasn't 12, but it was Wekiva with the lead coming down the stretch in the final 2 minutes. And St. Thomas Aquinas kind of flipped the script on them.
Especially with the ability being the bonus right now. Anything going to the rim, referees have had some tight whistles.
So what do you do? You're telling your girls, you're Tommy Betts. What do you tell them? Are you telling them the situation, the bonus situation, take everything to the rim, or you're trying to shoot threes? What are you doing?
I think everything goes towards the rim. If you can suck in the defense and get an inside-out kick for a three, I would take that, and we have to crash the glass. Otherwise, let's try to create contact and get to the rim. Put the ball in the referee's hands. It gives me an opportunity to maybe make some subs as well and set up our pressure.
Do you take as many quick shots as you can to crash glass?
Well, I think if you're taking quick shots, again, it has to be at the basket.
And somebody's got to be set up, right?
Yeah, we can't be taking one pass and just a shot from the outside.
Right.
And we also have to know who we're fouling on the other side. We're having that conversation now in the huddle. And who not to foul.
23. Stay away from 23. Moffitt. Three ball on the way. Rebound by 23. Brown Augusta. That was off the Jade Lewis attempt at three. Now they're going to milk some clock. You're going to have to start to foul. You still got a couple fouls to give before the double bonus. Right now it's 1-1, but making your free throws, you're playing with fire here.
Other piece, too, is, you know, I like my sportsmanlike fouls, but you got to foul on the shooting hand. You have to make them think about it when going to the free throw line. If we're going to foul, let's foul going for the basketball. Maybe the referee misses it, but we want to try to foul on the shooting hand.
Under a minute to go. Final 60 seconds of this 6A state championship game and a 12-point advantage for St. Thomas. And way down three from Jada Eves. He goes out of bounds off the Mustangs. Here comes Amaria Gordon in for Kanari Holiday. So a lot of three-point shooters on the floor for the Mustangs. But can the Raiders stave them off?
I think Wekiva missed an opportunity there with Ramsey catching the basketball in the corner.
Rylan Moffitt on the foul. Ninth team foul for the Mustangs.
Substitution for Wekiva, number 32, Kanari Holiday.
Kanari Holiday back in. Tommy Betts, if nothing else, is making sure he's using all his substitutions and doing whatever you can. McCarthy on the handoff to Eads. Eads straight up look at a three. That one looked good when it left their hands, but came up short.
It's three straight three-point attempts. Instead of attacking the rim, and they've missed three straight free throws on the other end.
Just simple math, I'd say that's 6 points they could have right now.
Hey, you're not that bad.
And a six-point lead would be cut in half. 12 points would be cut in half. Not only that, too, but doesn't that worry you a little bit? As good as Eads has been from three, you talk about the quick shots, but she doesn't have any of her teammates set up down there to get the rebound.
I'd rather see her turn the corner and maybe pitch the ball out and come back out and reestablish.
Well, Lancia Ramsey will go to the free throw line. We're under 30 seconds left in this one. Ramsey with 10 points, 7 rebounds, make it 11. She's had a real nice evening here. 6 foot junior.
Young lady has refused to be outworked this evening.
Come up with some big time rebounds here, especially in this second half, especially down the stretch. And on both ends, the offensive and defensive glass. And she makes both her free throws. And the 12 points for her on the evening. The drive by McCarthy. But lost the ball out of bounds.
See some seniors get a little bit of playing time here for St. Thomas. Wembley and Degenhart checking into the contest.
Number 3, Tierra Coleman. Number 21, Christina Wright. And number 23 is Arana.
Dakota Degenhart. Alexia Wembley. Classic move by the head coach, getting the seniors in that work so hard, not only in the games, but in practice.
Those absolutely.
Those are your players that get your starting five ready, right, Coach?
Man, it is impossible for you to prepare for these games without solid practices. And, you know, these things are truly team efforts.
With 22 seconds left in this one. And Tommy Betts does the same, gets a couple seniors in as well. Along with sophomore Soraya Lumsden comes in as a freshman, number one. That's Alexia Wembley with the basketball. Senior. And she's looking to dribble out the clock. With the freshman checking her. Zeros across the boards, and it's back to back. State championships for the Raiders. For the second straight year, St. Thomas Aquinas has knocked off the Wekiva Mustangs. 59-45 the final, and back-to-back 6A state championships for Oliver Behrens.
This Raiders ball club has done it with tenacity this evening, just unbelievable effort on the defensive end of the floor. Out-rebounding Wekiva 42-28.
Second state title in school history, and they've done it in back-to-back years. Congratulations to Oliver Behrens in his fifth season at the helm of St. Thomas Aquinas. And the 105th win, just as sweet as 104th win. But this one is a little bit sweeter because it comes with a huge trophy.
and a piece of metal. And possibly a ring.
A couple of rings, yeah. A couple of rings. Congratulations to Coach Behrens and the Raiders. St. Thomas Aquinas finished the season 27-4. Wekiva 25-3 as their season ends here for the second straight year. Once again to the St. Thomas Aquinas Raiders. Hard-fought contest, but in the second half, St. Thomas just took over, and they did it on the glass. They went to work.
I think Wekiva just find ways, you know, just not to be able to convert on easy buckets, and just St. Thomas Aquinas just getting all the hustle points, the loose balls, offensive rebounds, stick backs. It's going to be a nice ride home down the turnpike to 95.
That's right. They're celebrating in Fort Lauderdale tonight, bringing home the hardware. That's what the Lady Raiders of St. Thomas Aquinas are doing as they go back-to-back in 6A state titles. Congratulations to the St. Thomas Aquinas Raiders.
Like a jet, we are. Don't see us say I'm on a jet. We